Hello and welcome to your weekly insights through the cards. My name is MikaLeone-Pettit and this is for the week of October 3rd through October 9th. Moon mansions are in Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, and Aries. It's time to break through procrastination and get started on a project you have been delaying for fear that it may be too difficult. Gather your resources and all the information that you have put together so far and make steps towards making it happen. You may have a shaky start, or you may need to rethink or redo aspects of what you're trying to achieve, but that's all part of the process. Stay optimistic and keep your eyes on the end game. If you put 110% of your focus on planning, organizing, and anticipating challenges, there is nothing that cannot be achieved. Moon mansion energies are like internal drives, and conscious awareness should be brought to them to utilize these energies effectively. The Oracle, Pile. There is a fire that has been awakening in you that was barely a flicker before, and it's time to put this energy to good use, like mentioned with your internal drives with the moon mansions. Pile is here to help awaken your awareness and channel your fire correctly. Has life been too mundane and sedating? It's time to initiate change and wake up your potential, power, and possibilities. This helps to shift volatile, reactive energies into focused, unstoppable, creative energy. Astro job number one, conjunctio in the third house. Though you may be getting downloads of guidance on what to do and how to inspire yourself and others, you may want to rethink before you act on what's coming through for you. There is a trickster element to the air, and all may not be what it seems. It's a good time to watch your communication and your temperament. You also may want to watch the actions of others, for there may be lies, arguments, and theft through how things are communicated or perceived. Pay attention to the details and the fine print if you are making agreements or signing anything this week. Hematite will keep the channels of communication clear while keeping you grounded and helping to balance the nervous system in times that make you feel unstable or erratic. Astro gem number two, Via in the eighth house. Mid to end of the week, you may be feeling the urge to go within with all you have gathered at this point. Like a seed before it's ready to sprout, the urge is to pull all this power within towards inner awareness. It's a great time to journal and take notes on what may come up. This is naturally a more soft, feminine, shifting vibe that can be used to your advantage to get back into your natural rhythm and flow. Howlite softens energy, calms raging emotions. It helps encourage more conscious emotional expression and balance calcium along with emotions in the body. Your crystal card, Rhodonite. Known as a stone of compassion and an emotional balancer, it clears away emotional wounds and scars from the past, which nurtures love. This is what flowed through, and I hope it helps you plan your week for the best possible outcomes.